Hey guys, my name is Ali and I work as a data analytics manager. A resume is a great opportunity to make a great first impression. And if you're applying for data analyst roles, you want your resume to reflect that you know how to get the most important information out, you know how to structure it, and then you know how to present it in a nice way. By the end of this video, I hope that you guys have seen an example of how you can take a resume and use it to convey your skills as a data analyst. I do want to take the opportunity and say thank you to Emmanuel for letting me do this, letting me use his resume. It's the only one that I got, but I'm gonna make the most out of it. And I do want to remind you guys that if you guys are interested in getting some feedback on your resume, more than happy to take that and give you guys some qualitative feedback. So the first thing I want to do is I want to take a look at the content and the information in the resume. And then we're going to move over and we're going to look at the structure and the layout. And then I'm going to present a suggestion of maybe how I would structure it and maybe the kind of layout that I would create. And then I'm going to compare the two and just draw some conclusions based on that. So this is the resume that Emmanuel sent me. I think it's good that, you know, he starts out with a professional summary. I see that he's written over 2 years of experience. I think he could be a little bit more specific. It seems like he has more experience. When you pass two or three years, it means a lot in terms of how long you've been working as a data analyst. And then there's a little bit about web, SQL, database sources. It seems like he's done a lot of different things. It's very good that he starts with a professional summary. I just think that he can maybe tighten it up a little bit. And since it is a resume, you want to be a little bit to the point and specific, and then in an interview we can drill into the actual details. It's great that he's listed the technical skills, but there is a lot of different things there. I'm not sure if you need to include all of that. And also the way he the layout of how he has shown his technical skills, I'll show an alternative for that later. If we move on to his actual job history, you can see he works as a data analyst and he's been doing that for 3 years. So it seems like he's done a lot of very relevant stuff. I like that he said reduced report turnaround time from weeks to hours, 30% increase. I think that's good when he starts to use specific numbers. But you kind of need to know like how detailed do you go, because here he's talking about role level security, you know, how relevant is that? I noticed this one, which was biomedical research analyst. From what I understand, he's been studying for a year and he's been doing that in the meantime. When you have something which is so specific towards one area, I do think you should be a little bit careful. You should word it so that what you've done here can also be applied to something else. And then we got junior systems analyst. I think this also looks good, relevant technologies. He's included the right things. In terms of structure, he's done a good job. He started off with a professional summary, technical skills. You can see at the top, he has his contact info. He has a GitHub, medium.com. And if you include a GitHub and medium.com, make sure that you actually have like a couple articles on medium.com and something on your GitHub, which because someone might actually go in and look at it. And if you have a data analyst portfolio, that is also something you can include there. The technical skills are a little bit overwhelming, so we need to restructure that. Expertise and then education certifications, and then a little bit about what he does on the side. For a resume, it's nice if you can keep it on one page if it's possible. I have taken up the example of the after, which is just a suggestion of maybe how I would do it. We can just walk through and then we can do some comparisons as we go. So what I've done is I've tried to use a little bit of coloring, some white space, try and make it a little bit more visual. You have the contact info, same as this one. If you have links, make sure that they are actual links and make sure that they are clickable. On the summary, I've tried to be a little bit more general. I've written passionate data analyst with several years of hands-on experience. I have automated integrations from a variety of data sources, model data to optimize performance, and created dashboards to enable end users and create data-driven culture. It's a little bit more about who he is as a person. I just want his summary to kind of convey that I enjoy working with this, I like this, I'm passionate about this, and this is in general who I am as a person and what I have been exposed to. And then if we go down and we look at technical skills, and I've done the same thing as Emmanuel, I started off with the technical skills, but I have tried to categorize them in the different steps that you are exposed to as a data analyst. Just to group things where they belong, and I've tried to kind of convey graphically with the plus signs how confident he is in the different technologies. If you put 5, then you might be tested in it, and it should really reflect your skill set. But I think that's a good way of showing it, and it makes it a little bit easier to place the different technical skills, and it doesn't become so wordy. Soft skills, I put that on the left side here, just, you know, nice and concise. Education, we got a certification. I decided to take away 2 of the certifications. I just thought it was so specific, I'm not sure how much value it will give. And then we have the experience, and as you can see, I've tried to be a little bit more concise and just to the point. You know, created SQL procedures for ETL, and then I want him to mention the source names. That's it. Automated reporting using SQL and Power BI removed step XYZ and reduced report turnaround from X hours to weeks. So we're trying to be straight to the point. Notice how I've tried to use words that relate to the job that you will be doing and the language that we use in a data analytics environment. It's so much easier to use those words, and you cover a lot of the wordiness that he has had in his own resume. On the second one, you can see that this was the example. I wasn't sure if I was going to include it or not. Quantitative analysis performed on molecular studies. And then I've grouped the medical stuff kind of in a parentheses. And I'm telling the same story, just being a lot more concise. Also used a much more data analytics language. When he says created web-based surveys and reported data using SurveyMonkey, you know, I use extracted marking data from SurveyMonkey.com for analysis. So I'm saying the same thing. They're just packaged a different way, and I've used some ideas or thoughts on how you can group the different skills. And then of course I've thought about the layout, and I want it to be, you know, concise and to the point. And what's great is that if he looks at the fonts I've used, if he looks at the icons, he can use the same in the cover letter. He can use the same if he makes a data analytics portfolio. And together, I think it could become a really good package all over. So there are some of the ideas that I had for Emmanuel on how he can improve his resume. I'm looking for more resumes because I want to make more videos like this. So if you are interested in getting some feedback on yours, feel free to leave a comment in the comment section and I will get in touch. And with that being said, if you like this video, then give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos about data and analytics, then subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you guys next week.